the printed loop antennas arrived today. A real breakthrough in terms of reproducibility and quality. It's improving interference resilience of receivers because it's practically an antenna and a pre-selection filter in one. We successfully built lambda loops from wire, copper tape and aluminum foil some time ago. Indeed, their properties improved the reception of a LoRa and an SDR receiver. With the help of computer simulations, we were able to explain the working principle and the equivalent circuit diagram. Reflection loss and comparative field measurements were justifying our effort. Our experience is incorporated into a dimensioning tool for 5 different designs, and in addition, we created a catalog of frequency scalable types. Feel free to watch the previous videos on this. For higher frequencies, antennas are small and their structures must be correspondingly precise, which is a challenge. With this in mind, I thought that a PCB version might be perfect to meet tiny tolerances. So I started to design a first trial using KiCAD. Normally, a high-quality antenna is requiring high-quality substrate, which is rather expensive. In order to get around this, I came up with this trick. By cutting out substrate in the crucial areas, we are achieving the desired high quality for the antenna as well. And we can use proven dimensions of our planar antennas. However, we have to respect some production limitations. Depending on manufacturing tools and mechanical stability, slots must be wider than 0.8 mm and tabs must be wider than 2 mm. But no problem, we computed antenna dimensions for 2450 MHz, where the slot for the matching network is more than 1 mm wide. The entire conductive band is more than 8 mm, ensuring the two matching networks' conductors are wider than 3 mm. So we are definitely living within the production limitations given. There is no problem with the 868 MHz loop either, because its dimensions are scaled up according to the longer wavelength. Working with KiCAD, the radii of the structures and the XY coordinates of some points are useful. A simple spreadsheet helps me to calculate these. Here are the coordinates for the 868 MHz design and for the 2450 MHz design. The antenna layouts are fitting into each other, as we have seen before. In this way, we are making efficient use of the PCB material. Since the price is depending on the PCB's size, you're getting the small antenna for free. PCBWay, the sponsor of this video, supported us perfectly. For this unusual project, some questions about its feasibility had to be clarified. But no problem, the collaboration with PCBWay was great. Kudos to the employees. This makes implementing a new idea even more fun. There is certainly something for you too. Just take a look at the company's website. Take the easy way with PCBWay. The PCB's precision is impressive and the stability of the 1.5 mm substrate is absolutely sufficient for our loop antennas. Scratching on both sides with a knife, you're getting clean, predetermined breaking points. Then you can break the pieces apart, getting the two antennas. Smoothing the parts with sandpaper makes them look really clean. I soldered an SMA connector to the connections corresponding to the 15.3 degrees feed angle computed. You can change the impedance matching via the other connectors if necessary. Let's see, maybe we will construct a 3D printed mount for the antenna that also fits a coaxial feed cable. The 100 to 2800 MHz reflection measurement is showing us nicely the selectivity and high quality of the antenna. Return loss and VSWR are practically perfect at resonance frequency. A good indication that we have done everything right. Usually, lambda loops are resonating at multiples of the fundamental frequency too, as we have seen with wire loops. With this planar design, we are able to suppress higher resonances, which further improves the intermodulation resilience. The reason for this is actually very interesting. We explain it in a separate video. The resonance frequency is 2.5% below 868 MHz, which is due to the influence of the substrate's effective permittivity, which we have not taken into account so far. But no problem, 2.5% can be tuned, we were showing the method in an earlier video. The resonance frequency is increased by taking something away at this point. We can tune it exactly to 868 MHz. The impedance matching remains still perfect. Look at how smooth the return loss and the VSWR curves are, just like from the textbook. It is the result of the perfect shape we are achieving through PCB design. With the 2450 MHz version, the resonance is 11% below the desired frequency. Here, the permittivity of the substrate has a stronger effect because its thickness is greater in relation to the wavelength. You can tune it, then the impedance matching is then still good but not perfect. With the measurement results, we can further improve our Excel tool so that this type of PCB antenna can be dimensioned exactly to the desired resonance frequency. This is truly a breakthrough for reproducibility. The PCB concept works in the frequency range from roundabout 400 MHz to 7 GHz. We may create a catalog for a number of frequencies. By the way, which frequencies are you interested in? Write us in the comments. We will consider it in the planned open source project. PCB manufacturing is an excellent option for our loop antennas. Now we can reproduce them in any quantity and you can order them yourself. In addition, we will continue to make our tool perfect. We have not yet fully understood the higher resonances mode suppression, but we will figure out and explain it. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.